Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing a what's in my pencil case video because for some reason all of you guys have been really wanting to know what's in my pencil case. I honestly think it's not that interesting, which is why I never talk about it, but I made a what's in my pencil case video like 2 years ago. That's crazy. It was in freshman year I made one and I never made one again because I was like, I'm just gonna make this because I want to make this, and then I never really wanted to make it that badly again. But you guys have all been asking me for this video for like quite a while now, so I figured I think it's finally time I deliver, and I'm so sorry I haven't made this earlier. And I actually have two pencil cases to share with you guys today, so I hope this is exciting news for some of you. And if you stay tuned till the end, I'm also going to show you guys some stickers and stationery that I've just been loving lately because I figured I might as well make this whole video, you know? So let's go ahead and get started with what I have. The reason that I have two pencil cases is because this one's like a pretty large pencil case, as you can see. I got this pencil case from Mochi Things, which is a brand that I absolutely love. They have the cutest stationery on that website if you guys go check them out. Not sponsored. I freaking wish. Mochi Things, please sponsor me. I got this pencil case early last spring, I think, and I've been loving it. It comes with this cute little heart guy as a zipper, and it says, "Dear Moonlight, SDMN," which I'm not quite sure what that is, but it's just like major Sailor Moon vibes, you know? And I love the clear pencil case because you can see like everything cute that I keep in here, and I work really hard to keep it cute. And then I have this pencil case that's actually pretty old. It's a SES, a standard style pencil case. I actually don't know what brand this is. I know I just read the tag, but I haven't been able to find it online. So if you guys can actually find this online, please let me know because I'd love another one. I got this in California when I was like 15 and I never seen it again. So it's a very small pencil case and I really like it. But the reason I have two of them is because this one's really big, and this one's the one that I take to class with me, and I take, you know, wherever I need to go. But this is the one that has basically the essentials. Like, this is all I really need to like get something done, so that's why I have two. But let's go ahead and go through them. I'm gonna go through this tiny one first just because, like I said, this one's pretty compact and basic, so you're not gonna find cute stationery in here. I have 4 microns. These are size 1, 2, 3, and 8, and they're pretty basic. I have a tape on this one because I like to tape off microns when I first get them so I can keep track of what the new ones are and which ones are the old ones. You know, microns are pretty essential pens, archival ink, and they're just really good in general. So if you like sketching, micron pens. I also have this single pencil. This is a Muji pencil and it's 0.5 millimeter lead. As you can see, it's a wood pencil and it's really nice and it's really small and it's not too cute, but it's pretty aesthetic, so I keep it around. And then lastly, I have this Tombow eraser. It's a mono eraser and it's in the round shape, and it's basically like this pencil looking thing, but it's an eraser and it's super fine tip, so it's really nice for sketching. And I have the refills that go with it. You just refill this like lead, and you can find this on Amazon, I'm pretty sure. These are really nice though, and I definitely really love these, so I would highly recommend this if you're looking for a really good eraser because it works really well. But like I said, this pencil case is super basic, so that's literally all that's in here. And so let's just move on to the bigger one that I think everyone's been waiting for. This has been in a good amount of my vlogs, also my Instagram, if you want to check out my Instagram, and also Snapchat. So I think a lot of you are familiar with what this is, and I recently just put a bunch of new stuff in here, so it's actually really exciting to go through and look through this. However, the new stuff I put in here has not been tested yet, as in like I haven't been bringing this to class and seeing like what works for me and what doesn't, so I can't say that I'm gonna use everything that's in here or that everything is in here is even necessary. Sometimes I just put things in here because they're cute and that's just how it be, you know? But yeah, I just want to put that out there. This is not the most like tactical pencil case setup out there because I haven't even like tested it yet. You know, it's cute anyway. You guys keep asking for this video, so things are already falling out. Let's just get into it. As you can see from the front, you can see these two things that kind of like cover everything. So first thing that I have is, oh my gosh, this is an eraser and it's so cute. It says Fruit Ring Yum Yum eraser, and you take it out of the plastic to use it. Obviously, I just have yet to do that, and I don't know if I can ever bear with doing that because look how cute it is. It just looks like a candy. So I kind of just keep it in here for like aesthetics because it just makes me so happy. And it has cereal in it, and like, look how cute all the cereals are. I love him. An eraser, but will I ever use it? Highly unlikely. I just love him, so yes. And then I have this washi tape that I like to keep in the container because I don't want to get it too dirty. I got this from Artbox in London. As you can see, the sticker's still on it, and it was 250 euros. This is a My Twin Stars washi tape, and it's pretty cute. It's got some designs on it, but it's really skinny, so it's nice for sketchbooking if you're like just trying to stick something in. This is the only tape that I have on me, but it's nice to have tape, you know, just because you never know what you'll need it for. I just like to carry some tape with me. And then I have some sticky notes. So this is a set of two sticky notes. It has two bunnies on it, as you can see. One of the bunnies is pink and the other one's white, and it's just really cute. And they're just sticky notes. Sometimes you need sticky notes, you know, to put on things, so it's nice to have a couple with you. These are the ones I have because I have two colors to use. And I also have a ruler. I don't use rulers often except for when I'm cutting things and I want to cut them in a straight line with an X-Acto knife. So I keep this ruler with me. This is also from Artbox from London. So I do remember where I get things from. I just can't guarantee that you'll also get them because they're usually from here and there all over the place. But this is a My Melody ruler, as you can tell. It's really, really cute. And I just love it. It's a really basic plastic ruler. It was really cheap. I think it was like only a dollar. So I don't expect it to last. But to be honest, like, what are you really using a ruler for? Unless you have like a lot of cutting to do. But I don't use like cute rulers for that, you know? Like, this is my pencil case on the go. I doubt I'm cutting anything major. A tiny plastic ruler will do for me. So as you can see, My Melody. And now we're moving on to the actual pencil part of the pencil case. Let's start off with the actual pencils that I own. Where? I have a lot of pencils in here. Let me see. So these are all my mechanical pencils that I have with me. I have five of them. This one, as you can see, is super, super skinny. This is a Oto Sharp pencil from, I don't actually remember where I bought this from. I think I got this in New York, but this was mentioned in one of the videos that I made like a long, long time ago. And I do really like this pencil because it's a mechanical pencil, but it looks basically just like an actual pencil, just really skinny and small. So I think it's really, really cute. And I know this is just personal preference because I think a lot of people don't feel this way about really skinny pencils. But I really, really like skinny pencils. I like the way it feels in my hand and how it like, I don't know. That's just me. I think some people get really tired using small pencils. I personally really enjoy it, so I like skinny pencils. Yeah, this is just a mechanical pencil. I don't know what else to say about it. And then I have four cute pencils. I got these two over the summer, actually. And these two look like not mechanical pencils, I guess, if I get the light out. But they're really, really cute. This one is blue and has some squid guys on it, and he's like dancing. He's doing a little jig. And then this one has the same squid guy, but he's with some cherries. He's like wearing a cherry costume for some reason, and there's a cherry design on them. And I just love the way that these look. And when I have these mechanical pencils with the erasers on top, I try not to use the erasers, although that doesn't always work because, you know, when you gotta do what you gotta do, and sometimes you just need to use the eraser. But it makes me really sad to use these erasers, so I try my best not to. And since these are new, they're still looking pristine, but I don't know how long it'll last. But then I have these two Gudetama pencils that I've actually gotten a while ago, and I've just been using these. This one has Gudetama sitting on a little tart, and then this one has Gudetama with a little meringue dollop on his head, I think. It has macaroons in the back, so it's just a really cute two pencils that I like. And these have been working really well for me. All my pencil runs on 0.5 lead, so use skinny lead. It feels so good. Why would you not? And obviously, I don't need five pencils with me, but I just keep them because, you know, sometimes you take one out and then you leave it in your room, and then you go to class and you didn't have the one that you left in your room, so then you need another one. And sometimes that happens four times and you're left with one pencil. Am I the only person that happens to? Maybe. I love my pencils. When I was younger, I used to want cute pencils all the time, and I would get like the absurdly cute ones, like they were crazy. But these ones are a little bit more toned down in comparison if you knew me in middle school, but that's not the point. Moving on, let's see what else I have. So this is a whiteout pen that I also got this summer, and this one has apple peach juice, I guess. This is a peach juice box. It's just a whiteout pen, whites out things, pretty basic, you know, but it's really, really cute. Makes this really nice shaking sound, and yeah, peach juice, so good. And now I'm craving it. Great. This is not what I intended to do. I have these three Zensations. I don't know what they are, but they sell them at the RISD store. They're by the brand Zebra, and these are basically mechanical colored pencils, and they're really, really nice. I have them in three colors for just basic sketching, and it makes me very happy to have them. So this way, when I sketch and I want to add some color, I can without having to bring my entire pencil case set. These three colors is enough for me for like a basic sketch, you know, whatever you're trying to do. And so I have a purple, blue, and pink one come along with me. And sometimes you want to doodle something and you need a little bit of color, so I also have this white pen that I've been raving about on my channel for the longest time. This is a Uniball Signo white jelly roll pen, and you can find these on Amazon. I get mine on Amazon on bulk, attached, and so I always have one with me, and this is my favorite gel pen that I've ever had. It doesn't skip as much as the other ones do, and it tends to try its best to retain the white color. Sometimes when you draw a marker and stuff, the ink from the bottom just kind of seeps up into the white pen, so it doesn't always work really well. But this one has been holding up, and I've gone through like 5 of these, and I'm still using the same brand, so definitely good. I do, however, really like the Copic opaque white ink that I actually have right here, and this is what I've been using for the most part when I'm actually doing white details in my room on actual art. But you know, in my pencil case, I can't always carry that around, so I have this guy. But if you're actually looking for a really good white ink, this is really good, but you do have to use a brush, obviously, and it doesn't come in a pen form, which is much more convenient. Moving on, this thing's getting a little empty. I have some lead, obviously. This is a container of lead, 0.5 lead, and it has little bunnies on it, so yeah. I have 2 highlighters with me. These two are 2 different brands of highlighters. This is a Propus window highlighter, and as you can see by the tip, it just has one of those clear things so you can see what you're highlighting. I've never had a problem with not seeing what I'm highlighting, but apparently this is a problem the universe has tried to solve lately, because I've been seeing a lot of highlighters with this window. But I got this a while ago at a Kinokuniya, so if you're looking for this is where this is from. And then the other I have is a mild liner. I have every single color of every single mild liner that's come out, but this color has been my favorite for the longest time. So I don't know exactly where to see what color this is because I can't read Japanese, but it's like the reddish pinkish color, and it just comes out really nice on paper, and I love the way it looks. So yeah, I probably go to this highlighter more often than I do with this one, but if I'm gonna do intensive highlighting, I use this one just so I don't run out of my mild liner. This isn't really pencil case related, but I do have this with me because I need it. This is eyeliner, so you know, sometimes you gotta touch up your eyeliner. So I just keep one in my pencil case with me because I'm bound to forget like bringing one with me every single day. So, and then I have 2 pairs of scissors, and the reason I have 2, I don't really know. I usually leave one in my room, but for some reason right now I have 2. The first one I have is this little twin stars. Can you tell I like little twin stars? Scissors, and these, you pull up the top and then there's a little spring loaded thing that happens here. You push this up and then the scissors open, and then you can use them as scissors. To close them, you press it down and you push back down, and then you just cover it like this. I don't like having an actual pair of scissors with me in my pencil case just because it's way too bulky. I'm scared of dropping them because sometimes when I like fumble through my pencil case, things are bound to fall out, and if a pair of scissors falls out onto my foot, I'm very frightened. So I would enjoy if that did not happen. So this one's the way to go. And then this one's pretty similar. This is a little, he's really cute. It's a little alligator guy with the smallest legs I've ever seen. And this is from New Jersey, from a store that's across the street to Mitsuwa. I don't actually know what it's called, but I go there really often. But as you can see, this is kind of the same thing, except there's no spring thing. So as soon as you like take it out of the container, it opens up. Oh, I put his head on upside down. Oh my God. And so as soon as you open this, it opens up, and you have to close it and put it back in to get it to close. So yeah, same idea. I also have this pen. This is a multicolored pen, as you can see, and it also has cereal, so it kind of matches the eraser I had. I really like this obsession with cereal, I guess. Blue, green, pink, red. It has like many colors. It's a basic multicolored pen. You guys know what these look like. I had these in middle school and I just kept them around. So, but I really like the design of this one. This is one of my favorite designs I've ever seen. And there's a bunch of little cereal. He's really cute. I have these 2 glitter pens. I used to have 3. I've currently lost the blue one, so I need to rebuy it. But these are the Jelly Roll glitter pens, and I love these glitter pens. I just love glitter pens, okay? I've been keeping the primary colors around with because I think that's just the most basic set that I could possibly have. If I had more space in my pencil case, I would love to, you know, carry the whole set with me, but you gotta compromise. Red, yellow, and blue is what I usually have, but the blue one is currently missing, so I need to replace him. And lastly, I have this Muji pen. This is in 0.38 because skinny. I love these pens. I've gone through so many of these pens and I keep using them all the way down until the ink drains all the way down here, and then I get a new one. And I've been buying these off of Amazon, and I heard a rumor that these were discontinued. I don't know if that's true. Please let me know in the comments, because I'm actually not sure. And I freaking love Muji. Even though they're not that cute, they just work so well that I literally don't care. Like this does not fit the aesthetic of the rest of my pencil case, but I literally don't care. And this is like one of the only exceptions I make, other than like this Uniball pen. So that shows you how good these products are. Last random things I have in my pencil case is I have this one sharpener with a German blade. I have a bias towards German pencil sharpeners. I don't think that's even like a thing. Ever since I was a kid, that's been what I've been using, and I'm convinced that it's sharper, but I don't think that's a thing at all. So feel free to not come at me, because I know it's not a thing, but a little anecdote about me. And then I have these two little pig guys. I just think they're cute. I think they're really cute. This guy's sleepy and this guy's hungry. So, you know, two moods during college. They just sit on my desk. Sometimes I see them in my pencil case. They just make me happy. So I like keeping them around. And look how small they are. And that's everything in my pencil case. As you can see, I put all the pencils back, and then I put this tape and then this eraser on top, and then I close him up. And this is thing in my pencil case. Here she is. She's been through a lot. She is a really good pencil case because it has not broken, and I carry my pencil cases around a lot. This has also definitely been the cutest pencil case that I've ever had, ever. And I don't see myself switching out this pencil case for another one for a long, long time, unless I actually find one that I like more, which I'm doubtful is going to happen because I'm very, very picky about things. And now you know what's in both my pencil cases that I take to class with me. So yay. Last thing, like I said, I'm just gonna share with you guys some of my favorite stationery that I've been using. I've also been asked to do a sticker collection for a while now, which I'm not necessarily gonna do, but I am gonna show you some of my favorite stickers that I've been loving lately. So I have different names for different kinds of stickers. I don't know if they're correct. I don't think they're correct because I'm pretty sure I made them up. But these are my favorite jelly stickers, and they just basically are gel-like, and they're kind of hard, but they're kind of puffy at the same time. They're like clear acrylic. I don't know how to explain it, but this one, as you can see, has a bunch of sakura petals, and I just think it's really, really cute, and it has Mount Fuji and all this stuff. And this one is of various fruits, and this one is so glittery and so pretty. I'm like scared to use this because I literally don't know where to put this. Like, it's beautiful. What am I supposed to do with this? I'm scared to use them. I have a problem with being scared to use stickers, so yeah. But these two are so pretty. Look at them. I also have this sheet that's really pretty, and this is by Monogram Schedule Seal, and this was from China. Most of my stickers I get from Shanghai. I believe these two were also from Shanghai, so I'm sorry, I can't tell you guys where I got them from. But as you can see, this one is cosmetics, and it has a bunch of cute stuff. What's it called? Makeup? Yes, very. It's just so pretty, and the gold foil on it is beautiful. I've also been loving some vintage Sanrio stickers, obviously, because I love Sanrio and I would die for Sanrio. So I have, these two are some My Little Twin Stars schedule stickers. So they're really tiny, and they're meant to go on your planner so you can see what's like going on with your week, and it's pretty nice. I don't have much to say about that. They're just really cute. And then I have these sheets that I got, and these Sanrio stickers I got are actually from Etsy, from this shop that I will put right here because I don't remember what it's called, and I'm not sponsored by them either. I bought it with my own money, but this shop on Etsy had a bunch of like cheap stickers. They're less expensive than I'm used to because sometimes, as you guys know, if you collect stickers can go for a lot of freaking money. So these were pretty nice. They were like $2 or $3 a sheet, I think. I have three sheets of My Melody. These two are of My Melody, and then this one's of Little Twin Stars, and this one is of a character I don't know the name of, but I love him and I recognize him. He's a little like sashimi guy. There's a character that's literally just like meat with legs, and I love him. So yeah, I've been loving these lately too, and they're really holographic, and they just remind me of my childhood because I used to have a bunch of these as a kid, but Sanrio doesn't really manufacture stickers like this anymore. And then lastly, I have Mind Wave seals. I've been loving Mind Wave seals for the longest time. They're this style of sticker that I really, really like. As you can see, I have a bunch of them. This one's of little cats in different costumes. This one's of bunnies wearing sweaters. Another one of bunnies wearing sweaters. This one's of bakery foods, which is really cute. This is of grocery. This is of like Japanese festival foods. And this one's of specifically tempura shrimp, which is really funny. This one's of teeth. And this one's of birds and bunnies, and this one's of hamsters. So I love Mind Wave seals, and it actually matches my journal because I like to journal, in case you guys didn't know. This is my journal, and it's, as you can see, Mind Wave. And I don't even know how I came about finding this Mind Wave journal because I got it in Shanghai, but this is basically almost filled up. I've been writing since last year around this time, and I took a break over the summer, which is why there's not much left. But yeah, just some writing, you know, very interesting, I know. So yeah, this has also been a favorite. And last is this notebook that I really, really like. It's really, really cute. I got it over the summer as well at the same time that I got all those pencils. And these, what are these called? These folders? I don't know what they're called, but you can find these on like Amazon, and I'm pretty sure Mochi Things sells them too. They're just like these sheet folders, and they're so much nicer than like the 5-star folders I can get. This one's of Jinbei-san. I also have this one of all of these dog breads, and it has like folders inside, like it's like little file separators, which is really nice. And they also come in smaller sizes, so if you want like them for your stickers or something, you could totally use them. I just think these are so cute, and I just want to share that with you guys because I thought you would enjoy that. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me and for watching my video, and I hope you guys enjoyed finding out what's in my pencil case. And I will see you guys tomorrow with another daily video, like always. So thank you guys so much for watching and for hanging out with me, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Stay hydrated, take a nap. I will see you when I see you. Bye!